Phoebe, you want to ride it?
I do.
Phoebe, you know he was here.
Well,
we're going. Well, this is actually awesome.
Pan the rack?
Pan the rack.
Get something interesting?
What?
In the mail.
Yeah, no, it's just my paycheck.
Yeah, it's Cribbles and Ritz.
Like the cracker.
Laying down the income, serving you rhymes. About to get into the shiz.
Not a slacker.
I'll say you're welcome when you thank me for this time. Hit it.
Out of my way, I'ma slap you. Make 2-5K, gonna lap you. Got a new sketch like Wahlberg, waking up at 6. Gonna conquer. People say my life's in a corner. Think they misheard. Will that complete your order? Tasty.
Can I have some?
25K, 2025K. New salary is paving my way. 25K, I make 25K, yeah.
Hey, you were in chorus, right?
Why?
Got a gift card from the company. They can write it off, but it's gold to me. $400 for the whole week. Doing my time, yeah, I'm living free.
25K, I make 25K, yeah.
Wanna hang?
Sure. Can you drive?
Don't have a car, don't want insurance. Gotta show these fools I've got endurance.
Hey. Hey, Sonny boy.
This is just plain old wild outing. Like you're wild.
I just think there's a better way to resolve these here things, gentlemen.
Like what?
A duel.
3-1.
This trailer looked incredible. The visuals were on a whole different level than even the most recent LEGO games, and the music reminded you of how you felt playing LEGO Star Wars in the past. You were told that this great adventure would be available to you in just under 1 year.
Hilarious.
The initial release date was set in 2020, and we can assume what went wrong with that. It was pushed to the spring of 2021, then winter of 2021, and then spring of 2022. The details here aren't really necessary. The gist is that every employee was forced to work overtime, COVID messed up production, and people were either leaving the project or the company entirely. The game was just too big to be completed by those deadlines, especially since it was in the hands of an overworked and understaffed group. But TT Games pushed through, and after 2 years of waiting, people were finally able to get their hands on this game!
And it was... well, it wasn't what we expected.
The Skywalker Saga did phenomenally well, selling 3.2 million units in its first 2 weeks. Obviously, the LEGO Star Wars franchise had a lot to do with that, but there was also an unprecedented amount of hype surrounding the release of the game. Like, a scary amount of hype. And I don't mean in the sense of,
this trailer is amazing! It's going to be the best LEGO game ever! No, that kind of hype is normal. What I'm referring to is an insanely persistent deep dive into production rumors, the state of TT Games as a company, and what will and won't be in the game.